Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Welcome to another draft on Channel Fireball. Getting some Fate Reforged action here, and looks like I get to take a rare. Mob Rule is a card that we've found to be very, very good. I think that this is an interesting card because some people don't seem to like it, but yeah, our team thought it was quite a good card. It just kills your opponent in most of the games where you get to cast it, so seems like a good place to be. There's Avian Surveyor is the next best card, followed by Bathing Dragonfire, in my opinion, but even if someone's taken Bathe in a couple picks, that's fine. I'm still just going to take Mob Rule here. I like Right into Being as well, but Mob Rule kind of is. Followed up with, there's a Soul Flare, which is not really that great. It's a Hooting Mandrills, essentially. Lotus Path Djinn, which is a fine card. I don't mind taking. Also Rage Form, which is a fine card. Rage Form's not insane, but it's good with Mob Rule because the same decks that want, you know, good pump spells and all that and ways to get damage through, you know, want both Mob Rule and Rage Form. So even though I think Lotus Path Djinn's a little bit better, I'm going to take Rage Form because I think they're close. I don't like this card, Reality Shift. I think it's a lot worse than Lotus Path Djinn. And nothing else is really all that close either, so I'm just going to take Rage Form and see where we go from there. Ooh, Whisper of the Wilds may be a great pick here. It's very good with these two cards. Rage Form is good in red-green decks, and Mob Rule is good when you can, you know, accelerate and have like giant creatures in play. There's also a Bloodfire Enforcers, which is a card I've been pretty happy with in general, and Bloodfire Enforcers fits very well in a deck with Teemer Battle Rage, which so far is a deck I'm looking to pick, a card I'm looking to pick up, so I might actually just take Bloodfire Enforcers. Collateral Damage is a plausible card. I think it's a worse red card than Bloodfire Enforcers. And there's also Will of the Naga, which I think is reasonable, but if I'm going to take an off-color card, I'd rather take Whisper. And I'm not going to take Jungle Hollow or Grim Contest or Grimag Angler. So I'm just going to take Bloodfire Enforcers. See if I can do a little cutting off of red. Of course, now I think I might just take Will of the Naga. Just goes so perfectly in these cards. Also, Bloodfire Enforcers is by far its best in red-blue. I don't really want Anok Guide or Frontier Mastodon all that much. And I like the red-blue decks with Teemer Battle Rage. It won me a Grand Prix. And, you know, I played it all weekend in my sealed decks as well. So take Will of the Naga, I think, over like Windsguard Crag is another possibility. I don't really like Soul Summons. In fact, I don't really like Red White all that much. I haven't found Red White to be great, so I'll take Will of the Naga. And let's see what else we got. There's now a Dowsing Gloom is probably the best card. There's also a Whisk Away, Fierce Invocation. It's kind of Light Hunt the Week, I will admit that. Let's see. I could take an on-color land, or nominally on-color. I don't know if I'm red-blue yet. I can take Whisk Away, though I actually don't love Whisk Away in aggressive decks. I get the block first. Rite of Undoing, I think, is a worse blue card than Swiftwater Cliffs. I'm not going to take a red card here, because Fierce Invocation and Collateral Damage, I believe, are both worse than the other options. I don't really like Dowse. It doesn't go at all with these cards I have. I could see taking Hunt the Wake. Hunt the Wake is good in red-green, but, you know, I'm going to take Swiftwater Cliffs. I think blue is somewhat open. Now there's Rite of Undoing, but I believe I'm taking Gorswine. Gorswine is good in the 4-power deck. It's good with cards like Rage Form and Will of the Naga and Mob Rule, so I like it more than Mardu Runemark. And in fact, Jeskai Runemark is the Runemark of choice that I'm looking for here. This is an interesting pack, because there's Humble Defector, which I like in red-blue because of cards like Rite of Undoing, and one of the rites might wheel, or one of the collateral damages. There's also a second Swiftwater Eclipse. You know, if I end up being 2-color, the lands are quite good, and I do want them, but they're not as important as if you're 3-colors, and these cards do lend themselves to playing 2-colors more, so I think I just take Humble Defector here. Let's see, I don't really want Mardu Runemark, but there's nothing else here. It's a very late Grim Contest, but I'd rather just ship it to someone else, so I'll take the Mardu Runemark even if I don't want it. Now I might take the land because it's just so free, and I don't really like Breakthrough the Line. I've not had good experiences with this card, so it's good with Rage Form, though. That is kind of a thing. I'm just going to take Tranquil Cove. I mean, you never know. Like, sometimes you just open Wingmate Rock and you want to play some white cards. But we'll see. Well, let's see if we got anything here. No cards I want to play, and I guess pressure points the most likely I am to play, maybe, but still doesn't seem all that likely. Alright, this is fine with me. Jeez, that's more super late Grim contests. I guess I'm just gonna take Defiant Ogre. Cutting off red as best I can. Well, I was hoping one of the Rite of Undoings might have wheeled. I might take Refocus because it combos a Bloodfire Enforcer, though I could at this point just take Frontier Mastodon. And I don't think I want huge stone retainers. Alright, I'll take the Mastodon, even though kind of hope not to end up there. Though green is open. I mean, it got a lot of grim contests past me. Alright, there's the right. And I don't care too much about missing out on those two white cards there, especially since Arishin Cleric is not really what I'm looking for anyway. So the combo here, of course, being you tap Humble Defector and to draw two cards in response, cast Rite of Undoing, targeting it as the one the permanent I control, then one of my opponent's cards is the one I do not. I'm not looking to sort by color here. I don't really want to play any of these cards, so do that, and then let's look at these two lands. All right, well, that's a card to open. I mean, I've opened worse cards. So, speaking of rares, we're gonna take Sarkhan, hope to wheel Barrage of Boulders, or if that fails, Swiftwater Cliffs. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and add this to my picks. I think this is the right pick here. let's see. These are my spells. Let's see what my creature curve looks like. 4/4, and Sarkhan is kind of, you know, it's a creature, it's permanent. All right, what do we got next? No red card. Dead Drop's a great card, but probably not taking Dead Drop here. May just take Sign of Glaciers. Oh man, there's no team or battle rages. I just realized that. That's very disappointing, because that would have been great in my deck. May just take Sign of Glaciers because it's just a good card, and maybe this deck's not actually that beat down. And you know, this is fine in a beat down deck too, assuming the mana's okay. If I pick up another Swiftwater Cliffs, I'll be a lot more confident of that. I just don't think Treasure Cruise is really what I want, and Tormenting Voice I like a lot less. So yeah, I'll take the Scion. Thing is, there's also not another colored card, which is so insane. Like, Dead Drop is fine, but this deck doesn't have a ton of you know, ways to enable it. Ooh, this is interesting because there's Force Away, which is a very good card. There's also Mind Swipe. I really like Mind Swipe in aggressive decks, but Force Away has just got to be better. Maybe this will wheel. It sometimes does. Let's see, Snowhorn Rider. So that's going to just two, maybe three, four, five. All right, Mind Swipe's probably not wheeling, but I'm still just going to take Force Away anyway. It's a better tempo card, and if I'm going to be tapping out a lot, I'd rather just have the Force Away. Probably just going to take Warname Aspirant here, since I don't really see a reason to take Opulent Palace. Rakshasa Vizier is a cool card, but clearly not taking that. Could Fear Resistance is a thing, but I'm going to try to stay two colors if I can here. I've got, you know, double red, double red, double blue, double red, double blue. So even though I have a Tranquil Cove, if I can stay two colors, I'll be happy. Well, speaking of staying two colors, then immediately taking Windscarred Crag. I think I have to. I mean, I'd rather take Windscarred Crag and maybe try to get white cards later than take a white card, especially one like Feed or Mardu Hordechief, which is an early game card, and not have a way to cast it. So I think here I just have to take the land. All right. Well, I talked about Barrage earlier, but given that I picked up a Force Away and I have Rite of Undoing and Will of the Naga, I mean, maybe I don't need it as much. Though it's really good with Ghorsawan and Bloodfire Enforcers. Yeah, I mean, there's Mardu Warshrieker also. That card is fine, but I should just take Barrage. I will be a lot less happy if I don't pick up Barrage. And then now, of course, there's a Mardu Warshrieker. So look at that pick. Genius. Genius, I say. Now I probably just take Tormenting Voice, even though I'm not very happy about it. Some point there's some consideration to off-color morphs, just so I don't end up too spell-heavy. Yeah, the Barrage wheeled. I'm pretty sure, yeah, so that's fine. Now I'm good on Barrages and good on Tormenting Voices. Maybe I just take Sage-Eye Harrier here, just because I do need creatures and just cards to play off Mardu Warshrieker. Plus, I have some white lands, you never know. Thing is, I just don't want a second Tormenting Voice. Just not a priority, so I don't think it's a problem to take off-color morphs or just cards like Anak Tracker. I'm fine taking that. This is a deck that wants Whirlwind Adept. See, all this deck wanted was I'm gonna hope I don't play all these off-color morphs. All this deck wanted was Teemer, Battle Rages, and Whirlwind Adepts, and they're not good commons, and instead I'm just not seeing a single one. Just Sarkhans. Just Sarkhan Flooded instead. Actually, I hope I'm Sarkhan Flooded. I hope I see a second one here. That would be great. I'm going to pass all these Molting Snake Skins, because my opponents can play them to their heart's desire. Alright. Come on, second Sarkhan. Why not? Why not ask for the world? Ooh, I also like the double Barrage plus a Humble Defector combo. Tap, draw two, Barrage you. Bam. Well, it's not a Whirlwind Adept, but it's probably better. Summit Prowler is a great card. You know, I'll take Summit Prowler. I certainly don't need third Barrage. Wouldn't mind picking up a Crippling Chill, but you know, I don't really have a huge reason to be blue. I just have a random Sign of Glaciers and like a Force Away, but that's okay. I haven't seen another color which I really wanted to be in either. So Summit Prowler it is. And followed by Ice Feather. Even is good. The problem is I have no green fixing. It's not even clear that it's better than taking like a Woolly Loxodon, though I might actually just take Monastery Flock. I could also take Rugged Highlands and maybe try to wheel, but I'm not going to wheel a Loxodon or a Ice Feather. And I don't think, I mean, I guess this pack I'm going to see green cards. I guess that is kind of clear. So maybe I just take one of them. Or I could just take Monastery Flock and I don't know, it's just so, all these cards are just so bad in my deck. I mean, it's not even like I have a ferocious theme except for Barrage here. Maybe since I know green is coming, I could just take Rugged Highlands. Is that better than just taking a Woolly Loxodon and hoping to pick up Greenlands? Or do I just take Monastery Flock because I have a lot of good blue cards? You know, I'm just going to take the Monastery Flock. Maybe I should try to jump on the green train here. Well, immediately see another Woolly Loxodon. Yeah. I don't need another Barrage, Snowhorn Riders. Kind of like a worse Woolly Loxodon. Yeah, immediately punished by getting past a pack with three good green cards and just another Monastery Flock that I don't want, another Barrage, which I don't want. Alright, I'm going to take Woolly Loxodon here. I think, again, it's strong enough, it's stronger than Snowhorn Rider, so I should just take it. Alright, now I just take Rugged Highlands and roll with the punches, as it were. Savage Punch actually would be good in this deck. I don't really need active trees, and I didn't pick up any of the collateral damages that I saw, so take the Rugged Highlands. At this point, do I just take Thornwood Falls, or do I take Force Away? Actually, I'd probably just take Canyon Lurkers. Canyon Lurkers is good with Rage Form, and it's good with the double Barrage of Boulders. Alright, I think it's just safer just to do that. And alright, Summit Prowler. Now we're getting somewhere. These cards are good. Hey, don't get me wrong, I like Treasure Cruise, but Summit Prowler is kind of what I'm in for here. It should have just been red-green, though. I don't know. I kept seeing Grim Contest. I saw a late Hunt the Week, but that's not, like, spectacular. Let's keep track of what we got here. All right, well, there's the Whirlwind Adept that I wanted. Jeez, that's a late Mystic Monastery. And there's a Bloodfire Expert. I like Whirlwind Adept. I think I have to take Bloodfire Expert. I just need three drops, and it's good with the two Barrages. It's good with Will and Naga too. I mean, it's just safer to take Bloodfire Expert, I think. All I wanted was lame cards, and I just didn't see enough of them. Though I'm getting them now. I mean, I'm getting these late Bloodfire Experts. At this point, I just take the Barrage still. And, alright, probably not getting a whole lot more from these packs, is my guess. Yeah, maybe I just don't even bother with the green cards here. Actually, picking up those late Bloodfire Experts, I think, made this deck a lot more playable. Since, let's go sort by color or mana cost here. I mean, even factoring out the spells, I think this deck is kind of decent. Oh, so many Barrage of Boulders. I don't really need the fourth. I'd rather just take another Morph. I do wish I had taken Rugged Highlands over the Monastery Flock, the first one. I'll take a Weave Fade. I might actually play that card. And then I could have had two Rugged Highlands and, like, a Woolly Loxodon and, like, maybe one other green card. It'd be nice if I got Whirlwind Adept with, like, no cards left, but I don't think that's going to happen. Do I have any sideboard cards of note? No. I'm only playing one of my four lands, probably. Well, you know, this honestly is not the worst. Red of Undoing may be a little sketchy here, but got some combos. You can bounce Rage Form. The Manifest Creature still stays in play. It's good when people are like attacking your Sarkhan. It's good with the Humble Defector. The question is, do I want the third barrage of boulders? The well, I also want to play 20, so I'm going to take a look here. I also want to play 17 land, so I have to decide whether I would like the third barrage of boulders or... Here, let's take that out for the moment. Let's put Will the Naga at 4, Red of him doing it at 3. I think that's a little more realistic than the morphs at 3. I think my mana is going to support Scion, even though I have a lot of double red cards, just because I do have a Swiftwater Cliffs, and I am able to just play two colors. I don't really have any other needs there. All right. So this is 21, and I, like I said, I'm going to play 17 land. So do I play third barrage? Do I play any of the Monastery Flocks, which are just highly medium? I could actually play Weave Fade. I'm not even joking. I've got a couple Delve cards in. I'm just trying to combo Bloodfire Experts and barrages. Yeah, I should just play the third barrage. Barrage is just a great card. It's just very good in this deck, too. I've got Expert, Gorswine, Canyon Lurkers, two Summit Prowlers, Bloodfire Enforcers, even Sign of Glaciers and Sarkhan both combo with it as well. So is my last card a Weave Fate or a Monastery Flock? Neither of which are really great in this deck. I could play a Mardu Runemark, but it's just straight up Giant Strength. It seems bad, and I don't really want to play Rugged Highlands, Woolly Loxodon. That seems like a bad combo. Kind of leaning towards just playing Weave Fate. I was going to say I should just play Monastery Flock. Weave Fate is a nice little combo with Bloodfire Enforcers. Right now I've got a lot of sorceries, and this would be my fourth instant. That end up with four instants and five sorceries. That's a pretty good mix. This deck doesn't need Monastery Flock. Actually, it's only got 12 creatures. It probably does. Just as a morph. It's not like a card I'm super excited to play, but I think it's better than Mardu Blazebringer or Defiant Ogre. All right. Probably looking at, especially with the Tormenting Voice, not 13-4, but like I could do like 11-5. No, I should do 10-6, and then Swiftwater Cliffs. Seven blue sources is enough to cast Scion, Will of the Naga, Red of Undoing, and Force Away. And 11 red sources plus a Tormenting Voice should be enough to cast my Summit Prowlers. I do need double red, but I don't need triple red or anything. So, alright, this deck's kind of interesting. It didn't turn out great, but it turned out decent at least.